The plan is to use this Model S to tow this snowmobile trailer with the snowmobiles out of here through the snow and ice, going up that way. Got the hitch all set up. Now it's just a matter of driving up there and around the corner. Made it out, no problem, but there was a little excitement. If you see this here, this is all ice. This is a complete sheet of ice, same thing out here. And so I was going up this way, and so right here, the back end spun out since it's a rear wheel drive. But I was able to just correct it and go up here, go around, and now we're over here. No big deal. So, and if we look at the car, at the gaps between the front fender and the wheel here, let's look here real quick. About 3 fingers there. Let's go look back here. Maybe 2 fingers. So it came down a little bit from the tongue weight here. So the trailer is pressing down on the car a little bit. The trailer sits front down also just a slight bit, but actually my ball mount there is already like a 9-inch lift, which is extreme already. So I'm just gonna live with this, and since this is a single axle trailer, it doesn't matter so much that it's down a little bit. Overall, it sits pretty good. And so yeah, the car, basically the hitch is rated at 2,000 pounds towing capacity. We got two snowmobiles on here. They're each about 500 pounds maybe. So they would be about 1,000 pounds plus the trailer. So I don't know, maybe we got 1,500 pounds. Let's go high. Maybe we got 1,700 pounds. So really not bad at all. So this car certainly can tow this load. The question is, how efficient are we going to be with this trailer? We're going to be towing this here, which is basically a wall. So that doesn't make it any easier. Yes, it's V-shaped, so it may help a little bit. The snowmobiles are relatively aerodynamic. They're not like a wall anyway. So yeah, we got to take it out and see how good or bad it does. The question is, can we make it from here to Butte, where the supercharger is? That is 150 miles from right here. We have been close to 500 watt hours per mile towing our other trailer without that much weight. And so based on 500 watt hours per mile, that would give us less than the 150 miles. So we could go about 30 miles to Missoula, charge there to full again at the supercharger, and then see. From there, it's 125 miles, roughly, or 123 miles, I think Google says, from supercharger to supercharger. So maybe we could make it from there. The problem is Butte is an uphill battle, so it's going to be tough. So I want to do a test run first here locally and see what kind of consumption I get. So I can see if I even have a chance of making it to Butte. So, but if we can make it to Butte, from Butte we could make it to Island Park, to the cozy cabin, and that would be the snowmobiling destination we want to get to. So that would be the idea, that if we can actually do this, then we wouldn't have to use the truck. The truck costs us a lot in fuel to drive this 600 mile round trip to the cozy cabin and back towing the trailer. And we can't go really fast either with the trailer. And so we're usually only about 60, 65 with the truck. With the car, we would be slower. We probably would only go 55 here, just so that we can actually make it. I would assume that the difference between 55 and 65 will throw the consumption way up there, so it would be impossible to make. But we definitely want to go 55, so, and that's what the test run is all about today.
Beautiful day.
is an ice rink too here. It's only about, it's a little over a mile to get down to the paved road, and there hopefully it will be much better. So I did reset my trip meter and I didn't preheat the car today. I want to intentionally keep the consumption high so that I kind of have a more or less the worst scenario kind of deal. And it's not going to be a long drive, so we'll see how good or most likely bad consumption will be for this short little drive. And then when we come back home, the question will be, can we make it back up the driveway with this? We got really good tires on it, but it is only a rear wheel drive, and we're towing this trailer behind us, so that will create a little issue there. The driveway is extremely slick, it's a sheet of ice, but we'll deal with that when we get there. First, we gotta make it to the interstate and drive a few miles to the next exit, turn around and come back and see what the consumption is. We are about 8 miles into the trip, used 5 kilowatt hours so far, and we averaged 636 watt hours per mile. I had to pull up a hill and I didn't even notice the trailer was there, and I was at 45 before I even knew it. So now here, oh, we're already at 55, so I'm gonna set the cruise. And we'll just go 55 miles an hour here and see how that works out. We'll go a few miles here, not just to the next exit, but one further, turn around and come back and see what we get. But currently at almost 700 watt hours per mile, we wouldn't go very far with this car and this trailer. to turn around. We're about 15 miles into the trip. Used 9.7 kilowatt hours at 659 watt hours per mile. So it's not looking good to make this trip to Island Park with this car and trailer. I didn't expect it to look good based on what we have gotten with the other trailer. So, but yeah, we'll turn around and drive back home and see how that is. On the other hand, for the ride quality, it is great. I don't feel the trailer being back there. There is no rattling coming from back there at all. So this is really good. Yeah, the car just pulls it without complaining. Yeah, that part is really great. Unfortunately, the consumption is too high to do this trip that I would like to do with this car and this trailer. But hell, you can't win every battle. Okay, I just got off the interstate and I want to show you these numbers here right now, because those are the numbers we would basically get for traveling, I think. So the trip A there on the bottom shows 681 watt hours per mile. So that's about what we can expect going 55 on the highway with this trailer behind us. You can see there we drove 22 miles. About 15 of that were on the highway. So yeah, the consumption is pretty darn high. So from here on, we got about another 7 miles to get home. The speed limit is much lower here for the first mile or so. It's like 40 or 45. We got to pull a hill anyway, so it will go extremely up. And then it will be 35 miles an hour all the way home, and then we'll check the stats again. But I think basically, if I would do calculations, I would have to do them with 700 watt hours per mile for towing this trailer here. Well, let's continue the trip. I'm about to pull into the driveway, but let's shift this here into park real quick. I wanted to show you these numbers first here. So we're at 645 watt hours per mile, used 19.1 kilowatt hours, and we got 29.6 miles so far. So I wanted to show these numbers right now. So 645, it dropped a little bit with driving up here at a slower speed, and since it shows me over here the use as I'm driving, I noticed on the highway it was about 40 to 60 kilowatt hours just going flat out, while coming up here going flat out it was about 20 to 25. So there's a huge difference, obviously, just because of speed. So, and I stopped here before the driveway because, as I said, the driveway is super slick and we'll have probably a little trouble getting up there, and that would change these numbers here pretty quick, and yeah, probably bring them up pretty high. So What I will do, I will go relatively fast in and see if we can make it up there. Hopefully I can, not sure yet, we'll see. All right, we made it. This was actually much easier than expected. It was super slick, traction control kicked in, but these electric cars just do so much better. Having these good studless snow tires on it definitely helped, but you probably could see the ice. I mean, it's super shiny. It's extra slick. Already almost fell on my butt a couple times this morning, so. And it didn't affect our consumption too much there, so. The total stats there, trip A on the bottom, 29.8 miles, 19.3 kilowatt hours used, 648 watt hours per mile. It's 40% now. I'm not even sure where I started. I seen 70 about a mile down the road, so we used a good 30%. It doesn't really matter. What matters mostly is the efficiency there, the watt hours per mile. So, and you can see it's 31 degrees out, so we're just around freezing for this trip. And yeah, so towing this trailer with this car going to Island Park wouldn't work because the consumption is definitely too high. Can't go any slower, going only 55 miles an hour. There's no way to go slower. There's an 80 mile an hour speed limit in Montana, so that wouldn't be an option. So, and this car just doesn't have enough battery capacity to do so. That's probably where our Rivian would come in, if it ever would come in. I mean, yeah, that's a whole different story there. So yeah, unfortunately the consumption is too high for long distance trip with the snowmobiles here. We can do local stuff and we can do pretty good even in slick areas, snowy areas, getting up and down. So that is pretty amazing. So, all right. Well, this was it for today. Please give us a thumbs up for this video. If you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to our channel. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. But that said, also go look at our channel and go back and look at our videos that we have. If you're interested in cold weather driving, we got lots of super videos with different cars, with this car, with Tesla Model 3, with the Chevy Bolt, Chevy Bolt EUV in winter time on their extreme cold. So yeah, go back, look at our older videos too, because the information in there is still valid and relevant today. And you could get a lot of good information out of them. Also, go down below into the description and click the link to our Redbubble store. We got EV and renewable energy inspired merch there. You might be finding something you'd like. And also, go down below in the comments. Tell me what you think about towing with an electric car. Is that something you would even consider? I mean, to me, it's really cool. We're saving a lot of money. I would love to not have to own a pickup truck because they're expensive to buy, they're expensive to maintain, they're not cheap all the way around. So if I could do stuff with this, I would be super happy. Tell me how you feel about that. So go down below in the comments and leave us a comment what you think about towing with an electric car. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.